Another day, another contract. Well, I'm curious what an Oxenfurt drunk is going to have to do with a Witcher contract. This should be interesting.
Here to talk about the contract.
Contract? Ah, yes. Put my mark to something of the sort. Seems a creature's attacking lonely passers-by, abandoning their corpses in gutters around Oxenfurt.
Isn't that something you should look into?
Perhaps, but we've a ploughing war to win. Haven't got the time to clean gutters.
Let's talk about the reward.
Acquit yourself well and you'll not be disappointed. Redanian army's no band of scruffs. We can afford to hire a witcher.
And I'll always negotiate for more when dealing with Redania.
Very well. That I can pay with a clear conscience.
Not specifically Redania, just whenever I'm dealing with military and government people, I'm like, now's the time to ask for more.
I'll take the job. Need to hear some details.
You'll learn everything I know.
Like to examine the victim's bodies.
A corpse is a corpse.
I see the wounds. Might be able to tell what kind of monster killed them.
Ask our Sawbones. He'll know if the corpses have been burned or not. You'll most likely find him in the hut on the riverbank. Our impromptu morgue.
Ah, they use the old Sawbones terminology.
Any witnesses to these attacks? Anyone see the beast?
Some woman survived an attack. They say she's not been sober since. I'd try the tavern in Oxenfurt if you're willing to try talking to her.
Won't give me any trouble with the reward, will you?
Nah, I want this out of my hair.
Interesting. Well, now we know who the Oxenfurt drunk is. That explains the name of the quest. I was like, why is it called the Oxenfurt drunk if it's just about someone murdering people? Like, because she's the witness. She's right over here. Hey, lady. You ready to have a really pleasant conversation about the thing that almost killed you? Have I? Hey, bartender. Have I played with you yet? Oh, your name's... You have a name. I think I've encountered you before.
That little guardian.
Oh, I remember you. What'll it be?
So long.
Oh, will you buy a round for a victim of the beast?
Tell me about the monster. How you were attacked.
I'd need another bottle to get through it.
I think you'll tell me everything I need to know. Bottle or no bottle.
Yes, I will. I was leaving the inn that night. Might have had a drink or five. I'm sure I wasn't hallucinating. Something down an alley called my name. It was dark. Couldn't see what it was, but it wasn't no human. Of that I'm certain.
What makes you so sure?
I just know. This thing grabbed the hem of my skirt, but I broke free and ran.
That it? You didn't see much.
Don't believe me either, do you? Fuck you! Fuck you all!
I mean, it's not much of a story. She's just like, I was drunk and I got spooked and someone grabbed my dress. Oh, okay. Good story, girl. You tried, I guess. You'll choke to death on 3 pounds of steam. It's nice to find the right opportunities to use Axie, though. I mean, crap, what's it called? It is called Axie, okay. I'm not wrong about that. So we're examining this site. Not seen a whole lot yet. Oh, there's something. There's a little something right there.
A bracelet. Pretty worn. Silver under the gilding. Too big for a woman's wrist. Attacker lost it, most likely.
The attacker had silver on their bracelet. That's peculiar. If it's supposed to be a monster, aren't they all vulnerable to silver? That's like the whole point. I'm not sure. We'll see how it goes. Time to visit the medic. It's the only loose end still. Hopefully the corpses will give me more information than the Oxenfurt drunk has so far.
You the medic? I'd like to see the monster's victims.
Oh, yes. I've not had them burned yet. Must get to that.
You've done autopsies yet? Intend to?
Why would I? Beggars and vagrants. Every last one stinking of cheap wine.
Mind if I have a look?
In point of fact, I'd prefer you didn't sniff around.
Gonna make me come back with a written order?
Good grief. Pushy, aren't we? Here, the key to the morgue. Look all you want.
I'd prefer if you didn't look. Alright, fine, look. Gave up pretty quickly. What do we got around here? I'm just gonna start stealing your things now, don't mind me. Chronicles of Redania and some alcohol. Mine. Alright, now the whole job, I guess.
He was drunk. Someone dragged him over the cobblestones. Fang marks on his neck. Vampire sucked his blood.
Ah, well that removes ambiguity real quick. Is that supposed to be bloody rags, or is that an entire bucket full of entrails? What is that?
Vampire bites and the strong stench of alcohol, just like the other one. Fondness for jewelry, wounds on the victim's bodies, everything suggests a catacan, except this vampire likes the blood of drunkards. That's the way to lure it out.
Interesting wrinkle. It likes... I'm actually gonna get drunk for bait. That's interesting. So it's specifically attracted to blood tinged with alcoholic influences. That's different. That's certainly different. Let's take a look at the actual bestiary. It's going to be a... well, vampire. Forgot its own category. Vulnerable to Irden and Igni, the usual. This should be straightforward then. Contrary to popular belief, monsters are not all alike. Like people, individual members of the same species can each have their own unique traits, preferences, and weaknesses. A good example of this is the catacan, which once fed on the inhabitants of Oxenfurt. Perhaps influenced by its close proximity to the hard-drinking student youth of the city, the vampire had developed a keen appetite for blood spiked with a hefty dose of hard alcohol, and also baubles of gaudy jewelry of all kinds. The vampire had clearly thrived on its high-octane diet. It had grown exceptionally strong and gained the ability to regenerate lost life quickly, cause heavy bleeding with its claws, and, if all that were not enough, meld into the air and appear again behind an opponent's back. Luckily, the Quen sign meant the Witcher was well equipped to defend against the surprise attack, and the Irden sign would let him catch the monster in a trap. Might as well preemptively go to my oils, as I often forget to do. God, I have a lot of things now. So many things crafted. Alright, one of you has to be for vampires, right? I think I have all of the base recipes done at the very least. There we go. Vampire oil enhanced, 25%. That's something. That is something indeed. Oh wow, I really should have followed the dotted line, because the way I went had no doors on it. Alright, barkeep. The barkeep that recognized me. Get me shit-faced, which might be a little hard for a Witcher.
Oh, I remember you. What'll it be?
Wanna get drunk off my ass, and it's gotta be on cheap wine.
Trouble with the lass, or did your enterprise go under?
Neither, just part of the job.
I'll need you to pay in advance.
Pour, and keep it coming.
I'm gonna go catch myself vampire.
Once was a maid from Vico, Varro. Tight at night, she'd be loose come morrow. Early in the morning, another maid from Vico, Varro. Plowed with pleasure, drank with sorrow, till early in the morning.
Hey,
damn.
So he's doing well. Intentional drunk singing. Oh, we're going over here now. Alright. Just go ahead. You can do it, Witcher. Concerned townsman.
Our third mate was not handy. Gave it up to any man standing. Her lie in the morning.
What's the meaning of this? Such rudeness and vulgarity, young people these days.
All right. Sheesh.
I was expecting him to be the catacan, like he just transforms, like, aha! I hate singing, that's why I've killed everyone. They would have gotten away with it too if it wasn't for you meddling witchers and your two swords. Except you're really drunk right now, so you think you have four swords. Which is Zelda shit. I was talking about Zelda on accident.
I sense your blood.
Come out and fight, bitch.
I shall drink your blood.
Come on, cut the shit.
Hey, mister. How you doing? How you doing? Come out and fight, bitch. That's great. Oh, whoa. That was freaky. And now he's on fire, so...
Where's that damned catacan?
Well, that was a concerning amount of blood splattering everywhere.
I can hear it.
I sure can. Hey, buddy. Wanna come back over here? Wow, he got really far away, didn't he? Go. Where's he at now? It looks like I'm so close, but the point seems to move so fast. Come back here. I want to light you on fire again. It's fun. It amuses me. Are you inside the building? All right. Well, that's one way to track you. To trap you. It's locked. Key required. Is it under the doormat? Fishing rod. Winestone. What about the chest? Rotting flesh. Gross. Anything in here? Also locked. Oh, right. I can probably sneak into the roof. Oh, there we go. Hey, Mr. Catacano, you so incredible. Surprise! Ow, shit. Rude. Very rude. Do not appreciate. Yeah. Dear Deeth. Key to the hideout and trophy. Nothing quite speeds up a quest like this, like a vulnerability to fire. I see my drop button is triangle. Get rid of that garbage sword I picked up on accident. Yeah, that puts me back under. That was a heavy sword. What all you got around here? Just the sword? Oh, there's another corpse in the corner. You got more of them. Well, we gotta check out the other hideout, right? This key probably works for this too. Nope! Apparently not. Is there like a ladder here? Come to think of it, this is probably just genuinely where someone lives, huh? They don't necessarily all have to be vampire lairs. Dried fish. Just grabbing a few things real quick. Alright. Let's get our reward from the Redanian officer. Which I think, oh yeah, that's the port right there. Oh, convenient. That was actually a way shorter quest than I thought it was going to be. The drunk had way less. Oh, I'm the Oxenfurt drunk. I get it. I was going to say, like, she didn't really play much of a role. She was just like, this guy grabbed once. Spooky.
Killed the monster that was murdering folk. Turns out a catacan was prowling the city.
You speak true. But what on earth's a catacan?
A higher vampire. Particularly interesting case, this one.
How the hell could a foul beast be interesting?
This one liked alcohol. Had a hugely inflated ego, too.
What matters is you snuffed it out. Due some praise for that, Witcher.
So long.
Oh well, some details are only interesting to the experts. It's really noteworthy just experience boost I get from using Axie on a regular basis. That whole quest's reward. Like, I got like a 20% boost just from Axie. What's going on?
Where you think you're going, Mucker?
Why do you even care?
You're in a military operations zone, and our job's to collect the war tax.
Look more like you're collecting for a round of vodka to me.
I wonder I do. Will you be that cheeky when we accuse you of spying? Now shut your trap and pay.
Fine, I'll pay.
That, I understand. Exemplary patriotism, mate.
Fuck.
Alright, well that was a little bit of a surprise. Don't exactly feel like wiping out some Redanian soldiers right now, so I guess I'll just let that happen for the moment. But I won't be happy if that keeps repeating. Alright, I put it off long enough. It's probably right about time to visit Dijkstra, finally, as the final potential piece of help that we do before Ciri. Not that I'm about to immediately go for Ciri, but he's the one supporter I haven't talked to yet. Can I not knock on this door or something? Is this the wrong direction to go in? Am I in the wrong house? Is that what's happening right now? Did I go back here? Oh, right, he's like weirdly downstairs. The game's map always misleads you on how to get to this guy. It's like the one confusing spot on the entire map, too. Lots of blue and orange here.
It's everywhere. I see it all around. Hey?
Nope, he's just drunk. That's not a mission. He's just got a guy drunk off his ass. Well, he knows how to have a dramatic entryway, that's for sure. Hello, Dijkstra.
Got a minute?
I do. What do you want?
Surprised to see you still dabbling in politics.
It's quite simple, Geralt. I cannot be indifferent to Redania's fate. Call it patriotic concern.
So it's concern that compels you to bump off Radovid?
I think often of the country and its future. And the more I think, the clearer it becomes that as long as Radovid sits on the throne, Redania has no future.
Wasn't sure I should even ask you. Still not. But what the hell? I could honestly use some help.
Oh, my help. Very interesting. Do tell.
Wild Hunt's gonna attack Kaer Morhen soon. It's a sure thing. Looking for people, resources, anything that'll help me repel them.
The Wild Hunt? Don't tell me you believe that nonsense.
Hardly nonsense. Got a taste of it. A painful taste. On my own skin.
Sorry, Geralt, but I've my own pile of problems just now. I've not recovered my lost property. Your help, you might remember, left much to be desired. So I don't owe you shit.
Yeah, that's about as much as I expected. Alright, time to check out one of those DLC quests. We're back in Skellige again. This is one of the ones that they added post-release for free. We're down here in Blandare, in the main island on Skellige. Also got I do have a few exclamation points to look into still. They're just kind of floating around. We're looking for the village elder in this town. Ooh! A shopkeeper. I don't recognize this place very much, so I might be able to do a game of Gwent with this guy.
Would very well be your lucky day. Spending hard-earned coin, that's an art in itself.
So long.
Looks like I've played him before. So that means I've definitely been here before then. Oh, shut up. But Hjalmar, he's not here right now. He's not here to hear your boasting and your posturing. Hey, Elder, you live in a ruin, you know that? Anyone tell you about that? Taking your stuff.
Greetings, Watcher.
Hear about the missing miners. Might be able to help. What happened?
Well, we'd heard tales of silver in the northern hills, and seen as coins needed to ready longships for raids, we sent a few lads to see how much truth was in the tales. And, well, they've yet to return.
Might not be much silver in the hills, but there are monsters, definitely. I'll see if the miners came across any.
Thank you, Witcher.
That's the shortest introduction we've had so far to a contract, I think. Over in the hills, there's miners, and they may have encountered a thing, I guess. The end.
I'll do it.
All right, we're at the miners' camp. You stay here behind this tree, Roach, trying to do anything stupid, like float or something.
Miners' camp. Could find some clues.
I'd hope so, otherwise we're pretty SOL. Aha, the fire's lit. That's a clue. Whoever was here didn't care about fire safety.
Footprints. Human.
Might even be miners of some sort. Where are they leading to? Oh, hey Wolfies, we don't need to do this right now. It's cool, you just not- oh god. Sorry. I killed your prey and now you're dancing around while on fire. Whoops. Alright, who else wants some, I guess? Is that wolf floating? I think that wolf's floating. What, was everything floating? How does that- oh, it's an optical illusion because of the weird reflection engine in this game. It looked like everything was floating like- oh, what- wait, is it? Whoa. Something really weird is happening with the floor right there. That's freaking me out. It's like the ground is like multiple layers of like illusions or something. You are not supposed to pan your camera down. Wolfies, don't look at me. Don't look at me, I'm hideous.
Wounds caused by a blunt instrument. Ribcage smashed in.
Uh-oh. Awkward. Ow, rude. Oh no, they're all coming now. I didn't want to, they wouldn't stop. Oh. It's become a chronicle of me wiping out white wolves. Oh god. They're dying in synchronicity with each other. That almost makes it creepier. Well, I guess I'm gonna have a lot of wolf hearts. Anyone paying good money for wolf hearts around now? And wolf livers? Don't want to alarm you, but I may have killed them in mass. This may have been a great culling of the local wolf population. Hello, Branch.
Wind didn't fell these trees. Something else did. Something big.
Something big that I'm gonna set on fire. Spoilers.
Oh, there's a big cave. This would be the right place to look. Oh. I'm supposed to actually interact with something before I come in here, apparently.
Crushed bones. Human bones. A rock troll looks like.
Aw, oh, they're hard to set on fire. They're made of rock. Talk to the rock troll to decide his fate. How many people you've been killing?
When the wind come in, so when the troll...
Ow. What? What? He just one-shot me? Crap. Well, that was an experience. The games are like, talk to the rock troll and decide his fate. And I walk in there, he's like, I'm gonna kill you. And then I died instantly. I'm like, oh, that's not how talking works, game. I feel like you may have manipulated me in some way that kind of misrepresented the situation. You're on fire. Oh, they do. No, he actually doesn't burn very much. Burns a little bit, though.
Stop it. I want to talk. Wait, I want to talk.
Talk? But you come. Or call you wham-a-wham like this?
Exactly. Why do you wham-em?
Things in walk troll house. Trolls say outmans. But they wham-a-wham troll rocks. So troll wham too.
From what you say, they were asking for trouble. I'll let it slide, this time. But kill any other humans, and I'll come back and cut off your head. Understand?
No! Words are words many. Hurt head.
Let me try again. Wham-a-wham-mans again. I'll swish-a-swash-a-swunk you.
Oh. No more troll wham. and this man take for be good man and no swisher swash.
A no swisher swash. I'd buy, sir. That was an experience. Yeah, those guys kind of had a death wish. It's not necessarily like he was morally justified to kill them because it's murder, but also trolls are really stupid. And in this situation, it kind of seems like the freaking humans had a death wish. They're running into a troll lair and they're just like, and the troll's telling them to get the fuck out, and they're still going to sit there like, we're going to try to mine now while this giant rock troll yells at us. That'll end well. It's like, at some point, I don't feel bad about the idiots that have a death wish. Hello, creepy giant. How you doing? You doing all right? Oh, Cyclops. Technically different. Oh, God. He tracks better than I thought he would. All right. That pretty much killed him, actually. Oh. Oh, initiate round two. Try to get in the way of any charges he does. Cyclops down. Monster saliva. Gross.
Might want to look around some.
Yeah, a little bit. Hard times.
Blood hasn't even dried.
Wandered straight into a quest.
Wasn't a fair fight. Didn't stand a chance.
I mean, I think I know what did it. Don't want to spoil it, but I think it was the giant. It's probably the Cyclops.
Trail's fresh.
I'm actually looking further into this?
Blood hasn't even dried.
What am I going to find here? Huh. We'll see where it goes, I guess. Blood? Someone must have gotten away. That's must be what we're tracking here. There's bad sounds in that direction, though. Oh, uh-oh. They might be dead, because they're covered in neckers. Wow, I missed all of them again. Impressive. There we go, a little more success there. Ow, rude. Rude. Being very impolite, neckers. Now you're in pieces, so how'd that work out for you? Yep, there's the body.
Another victim.
There's a letter to Yane. Could have been a trap? Was someone being, malevolent? There we go. I'm like, what's a word that fits the sentence? I completely lost my train. Yane, my dearest son. Ill is our lot of late. Singa's husband's ship crashed in a storm during its last expedition. Bjorn survived, thank the gods, but weeks will pass before his captain builds another, and meanwhile, life must go on. We weren't taken on for the building, so he's earning no coin. We're eating our winter stocks now, and I fear to think what we'll do when they run out. That's why I'm sending Singa to you and asking for your help on behalf of us all. If you can, find work for Singa, and then Bjorn and I will come to Kaer Trolde to stay with you. Perhaps there's some work for Bjorn with you in the forge? If work is scarce around Kaer Trolde as well, lend Singa a few coppers, at least. We'll go give it back with interest once we're out of this plight. With belief in your good heart, and thanks in advance, your loving mother. Delivering the letter, alright. It's gonna be a bit of a ways away, but we're gonna be visiting Kaer Trolde in a moment, right after I deal with the miner situation. Alright, he may not be happy to hear that I didn't kill the troll, but he also probably won't be happy to hear that his miners are idiots. So really, I don't really have good news to deliver today.
Greetings, Watcher.
Your miners are dead. Not one of you knew a troll lived there?
We'd heard mention of it, but...
But greed went out over reason.
Not your place to judge us. What about the troll?
Left him in peace. Advise you to do the same.
Turncoat, you mean? What kind of monster slayer are you? Out of my sight.
A monster slayer that doesn't deal with you guys being freaking idiots. But have fun, you... I'll enjoy my free experience and knowing that I didn't kill somebody for your own mistakes. Wasn't expecting another reason to come back to Kjotrolda again so soon, but here we are.
Maybe a nice little axe.
Kongs are wagging about you.
What's this?
It's, adornment.
Why not?
I engraved it.
Melt this blade and forge it again. A sword for cutting, not looking pretty.
You guys look like you get along great.
Greetings, White Wolf. I suspected you'd come by. Bah! I was sure of it.
Oh, yeah?
The best-stocked armory in all Skellig is right here at Kjotrolda Castle. Everyone knows it.
I'll gladly see for myself.
Take your time. Give them all a careful look.
I hate to tell you, but I had no idea that you existed until I happened to wander into this corner.
Wouldn't mind a look at your stock.
He's not the actual person for the quest. The other guy is. Just wanted to talk to him first in case I could do quest... He actually sells relics right off the bat. That's impressive. They're all Undvuk set, though. And not particularly impressive. Saddlebags are 100 weight. Let's see. Compare. I can't... Oh. Mixing up buttons. L2. Same quality as what I already have. Same stamina as I already have. Better fear blinders. I'll grab those real quick. The rest is the Undvik set. And a bunch of recipes for stuff I probably don't care about. Oh, maps. Might as well grab these. Yeah, I mainly figured, hey, let's play some Gwent against this guy. Since he's around. And also offload some of my way too many items that I'm not super interested in. Like this thing. Dirgdith. Axie and Irden and Ard. Not bad. But not my priority spells for sure. That's not particularly interesting, but valuable. Daystar. Ash Rune. Black Unicorn. Cool name. Not the most interesting weapon. He has proper value for these items, too. He actually pays out for them. And this should pretty much clear him out. Alright. That gives me 30 clear... a space of 30 on weight, and he clears out all of his income. So what do you sell... Should probably look into something really valuable around here. Silver plate. Steel plates. Something for more, like, something more, meteorite based? Yeah, I'll let him be. I know this place exists now, so if I really need to, I can find it again.
Wouldn't mind a few rounds of cards.
Everyone just kind of stares blankly at you whenever you challenge them to a game of Gwent. Alright, monster deck, did I get anything new for you? Nope, just those garbage ghouls and neckers that I don't have a lot of interest in paying any attention to. Yeah, I will think I'll avoid. Let's stick with my current build. Did I draw? Let's see if I can draw a spy. One spider? All three crones. Ooh, lots of heroes. Let's try to get these crones out of here, though. Commander's Horn. Alright, Commander's Horn and Weather. I'd rather have drawn monsters, but it's better to have useful cards than to have a whole bunch of crones in my deck. Since they're useless to me in that capacity. But I'm not going to be drawing any more cards because I have no spies, and since I'm not Northern Realms, winning a round does not give me another card. You playing a Siege Expert first? Let's throw some spiders on the field. Here they come. Yahtzee. What you got, buddy? That's a tough card. That is a relatively powerful card. About as powerful as all my other cards, alright? Let's buff him up. Try to keep pace. Is he gonna scorch me? No scorch yet. He's just playing more hero cards. Which means I can't weaken them, but I don't bring frost into this anyway, so I'm not overly concerned about that. Dare I throw the crones down? That'd be a bad idea. I should play a hero instead. Yeah. I should save the crones for next round, because I can Commander Horn them too. He passed. Alright. Then I will pass. And one of these things will stay on the board. And then I can throw everything at him next round and see if I can pass him. So we have one spider on the board, and I can summon more. I'm gonna try to bait it out with this guy. He probably has a scorch in his deck. So if he has one on, if he has one now, I'm gonna have this six on the board, and when I buff it up, he'll probably target it with that. Then I'll play Crones immediately afterwards, when I don't have to worry about him wiping them out. He's less likely to have two Scorches, but who knows. A noteworthy threat is I think he's using the same ability I always use. Yep, he has Clear Weather. So that combats my ability to counter him to some extent. Gonna play Heroes for a few turns to try to deal with the fact that playing Heroes for a few turns will allow me to avoid playing the Crones for a while. See if he scorches or not. It's a good... I often will... In previous rounds, you'd know that I would often throw the first round to get a card advantage. I mostly avoid that when playing against something like this. Because the Northern Realms has a benefit for winning a round, where if they win a round, they get an extra card. So it's actually in your best interest to make them never win a round. Alright, I baited out his leader ability. Now to go with the Fog, because he can't use his leader ability again. And I believe I'm using the weather-based leader ability, so I can actually draw another anti-siege weapon card anyway. Which I think I'll do now. Still waiting for him to play a Scorch if he has one. I only have another... I don't have another rain? That's a bummer. Well, now I'm double fogged. Suck it. That was pointless. I forgot I didn't have another rain. I don't think I have more than one rain in general. Like, I still haven't drawn one. Alright, well, I'm winning anyway, so I guess it's not that big of a deal if he destroys my Crones. But we'll see what happens, if he has a Scorch or not, or if this is just him being defeated. What you got, buddy? That's it? Alright, more fogs. Did we play four fogs in one round? Neither of us had anything else. Alright. What do I get from you? Emil Regis Rux to f-f-f-f-f-f-f-f. That's probably a hero card, not that guy. Maybe Northern Realms? Nilfgaard? There we go. I think it was one of these. Probably, we'll get three random cards. Cancel your opponent's leader ability. I probably just got that one, I assume. Unless it was like an actual unit and it just has a long ass name. Take a quick look through for a new card. Oh, there, that's it. It's a Northern Realms card. Oh, it's a neutral card, it looks like. Men, the polite ones at least, would call me a monster, a blood-drinking freak. It's a five-power neutral monster melee card. Interesting. Don't know if I'd use that with any of my decks. Yeah, I don't know if anyone needs a five-power card right now. Let's see. Do I have anything that's weaker than five among my monsters? Not really. Just a fork tail. And a werewolf. And everything else has muster or something. Yep. Well, I could replace a card that I don't think is as cool. Let's get rid of the fork tail. And replace it arbitrarily with this cool vampire character. It's too bad he doesn't count as another, like, vampire for muster purposes. Oh well. At least we got something new. Alright, how about now for the guy that we're actually here for.
Mind your manners.
What?
Swords need thumping.
Hey, what?
Got me eye on you.
Am I here for you, actually?
It's, adornment.
Hey. I engraved it.
Melt this blade and forge it again. A sword for cutting, not looking pretty.
Dude? Can I stumble you out of that animation for a second? And you pay attention to me?
Mind your manners.
No, I'm trying...
Doors need thumping.
No, I have a letter to deliver to you. What the f... Are you glitched?
So you're back. Was right, wasn't I?
Was I talking to the wrong one of you?
Looking for someone who can make me a master quality breastplate.
Never known a master who wasn't a dwarf.
Fergus, perhaps? Say he's holed up somewhere in Velen.
So long.
Can I not turn the quest in? At all?
Mind your manners.
I'm supposed to deliver this... do you not count as the smith without... Oh, you're an armorer. Do you not count as the smith? Is there supposed to be someone else here that I'm not seeing? Don't tell me another free DLC quest is hopelessly glitched just like the last one was. What if I wait? I'll wait a whole day. And we'll just see if he mysteriously shows up and he just wasn't here a second ago? Maybe. That can happen. Oh, there's someone new here. Okay.
You've no respect for our
customers. Interested in the weapon? There's a tale behind every item I've got.
What are you peddling?
Might as well work through some more of our backlog of stuff. Horse fear level, okay. This armor, not something I want to use. Get rid of that. Heavy armor. Nilfgaardian. Axemans. Mostly stuff I don't really need. That's a not a good saddle, right? Yeah. So, yeah, I'll get 100 for that. Progress, there's so many runes. I should probably just start using some of these more. Alright, that's a nice dent. And I got rid of half of my equip load while burning through his money. We'll play another game of Gwent, I'm not above it.
Wouldn't mind a few rounds of Gwent.
Do it now while I see him here, right? Play a game of Gwent now before he gets the news about his family being destroyed. Is that insensitive? One vampire, one crone, and a Siri, that's not bad. Would like to draw a spider if I could. Clear Weather is a good defensive card in case I get surprised. Decoy also has its purposes, but it may be more useful just to have an actual monster card instead. Rain versus Fog. He's playing a Scoia'tael. Probably not a lot of siege weapons going on with him. I drew Scorch. Alright, that'll have to do.
Spymaster, go!
What do I draw? Crap, I forgot about my- Damn it! I did it again. Keep forgetting about my own strategy of like how you're not supposed to do that. He gave up already. Alright. I'll throw one guy in there that doesn't have muster and win the round. And that'll keep him on the board anyway because of my ability, so I'm not even wasting a card. He just let me win a round without actually spending a single card. That's pretty incredible. Alright, let's go big and scary with let's put the vampires in there. They're being shielded right now by the Leshen or whatever, the fiend. So he can't really scorch me right now anyway. Oh, 3. Unfortunately, the fiend's also shielding my my ability to use my own scorch, but that's fine. If I have a lead, I have a lead after all. You get in there, Dandelion. There's the scorch. Alright. Pretty much as expected. Just gonna start throwing guys in there at this point. There we go. I'm nice and scary now. He has another Scorch. Okay. Goodbye, Crones. Unfortunate, but I still have more to throw in there. What do you got, buddy? Got anyone strong to play? There's a 10. Immune to Scorch. Let's see. I'll just start throwing weather stuff out there, I guess. Since it won't affect me. And it lets me stall for a moment. Yeah, you're not gonna play him in the ranged row now, are you? And I'll go searching for a rain, just to be complete about it, and also continue to stall. Commander's horn, huh? Oh, he's got a 12 on the board. That opens me up. Wipe that guy right off. Medic, ranged, it's gonna bring back his 12, right? Sure is. Alright, he's got the minor advantage. I can press it, though. Still have more monsters to play. What's your last card? Another medic. Okay. Not bad. He held his own for the most part. But my weather helped clear... the weather didn't help at all, actually. But, I still had one more monster. And so I win the round. Unfortunately, now that I've taken his gold and his Gwent card, I have bad news for him. Acer Veranid. Two brand new cards, I'll take it. Probably a Nilfgaard card. Acer Var Anahid. Six power ranged. It's something.
Interested in the weapon? There's a tail behind every item I've got.
Think I have something that was meant for you.
A letter from me mom. Says here me sis was bringing it. How'd you come by it?
Came across some bodies in the woods, victims of a monster attack. Found this letter on one of the dead, a woman.
Singer's dead. Ah, told her and mom so many times, come over, live with me. No, I had to stay on Pharaoh. I gotta send someone to fetch her body.
I'm sorry.
Thanks for bringing word. Not every man will go to the trouble. Here, take this.
That's rough. One of your options is to deliver the letter but then just not say she's dead. It's like... saying her dead is more important than the actual letter, I would say. Oh, no big deal, it's just, she's dead. It's not like I'm not exactly sparing grisly details or anything, it's just like, just basic information about whether or not your family's still alive. Alright, well that's enough for this episode, guys. Thanks for watching like always. Not sure, we might do the Gwent tournament next episode. I'll make my mind up then.